In my last video comparing the Insta360 X5 with the DJI Osmo Pocket 3 and Action 5 Pro, one issue that really stood out was the X5's noticeably weaker HDR performance. And this wasn't just something I noticed in side-by-side comparisons, it was something that genuinely affected a lot of my X5 footage, to the point where it felt like it was ruining some shots. But after I posted that video, someone in the comments asked if I had tried the new Adaptive Tone mode. At the time I hadn't, because I hadn't yet installed the latest firmware update which introduces this new mode. Adaptive Tone is designed to enhance dynamic range, brightness, contrast and color, so it sounded like it could potentially help close the gap between the X5 and more traditional non-360 cameras. So I updated the firmware and decided to rerun the same test, this time across four modes on the X5, basic 8K, AK with Adaptive Tone, 5.7K with Active HDR, and 5.7K with both Active HDR and Adaptive Tone. A quick side note before we start, there was a small piece of dirt on the lens during these tests, so you'll see a faint mark in all the footage. Anyway, let's start with the standard 8K footage. In this shot, where there's a strong contrast between shadows and highlights, you'll notice that the area beyond the passage looks completely blown out. Now let's turn on Adaptive Tone and see what changes. At first glance, the difference might seem subtle, but if you compare similar frames, especially in scenes with bright highlights and deep shadows, you'll notice that Adaptive Tone helps retain more detail. The sky has more blue in it, and the overexposed concrete is visibly more grey than white. So how does this compare with the Active HDR setting, which is only available at up to 5.7K resolution? Well, in the same test frame, Active HDR had a similar outcome to Adaptive Tone. So you might be wondering, is Adaptive Tone just as good as Active HDR? Well, I dug a little deeper and found a frame where Active HDR acts differently. Take a look at this shot. Notice how the indoor area is brighter with Active HDR, whereas in the 8K Adaptive Tone footage, it remains quite dark. Now here's where things get interesting. At 5.7K, you can actually enable both Active HDR and Adaptive Tone together. With this combination, the X5 retains the most highlight detail we've seen so far, with the sky and brighter areas showing even more detail. Now let's check out another comparison, looking at how each of the four modes handles the same scene. First, plain 8K footage with no Adaptive Tone or HDR delivers the most blown out highlights, especially in the brighter parts of the frame. Next, 8K with Adaptive Tone produces a more balanced exposure overall, but since the exposure is lower, indoor areas become noticeably darker. Then we have 5.7K with Active HDR. This keeps the indoor area brighter like the plain 8K footage, yet manages to keep a good amount of highlight detail and avoids too much clipping outdoors, striking a better balance between the two extremes. Finally, adding Adaptive Tone on top of Active HDR once again reduces the overall exposure, and the outcome is the most detail in brighter areas so far. Interestingly, the way Adaptive Tone exposes scenes is closer to how my iPhone and DJI Osmo Action 5 Pro exposed the same scene, and feels like the most natural result. So overall, Adaptive Tone seems to have a very positive impact, especially in scenes with high dynamic range. But here's the challenge with 360 footage. Depending on where you're looking in the scene, the ideal exposure will vary, meaning a single global exposure always ends up being a compromise. So if Adaptive Tone reduces the overall exposure to protect highlights, does that mean the darker areas will end up underexposed? Well, when we open the clip in Insta360 Studio and pan toward the darker side of the scene, you can actually see an automatic exposure adjustment take place. The image brightens dynamically. This suggests that Adaptive Tone is able to rebalance the exposure based on your framing. In contrast, if we work on a clip without Adaptive Tone, this dynamic exposure shift doesn't happen. The exposure stays locked no matter where you pan. So going forward, I think Adaptive Tone is definitely worth enabling, especially for scenes with tricky lighting. Just keep in mind that it does come with a trade-off, increased processing load and heat generation, which could be a concern.